Okay, you know what? That's fair. That's fair. I updated the extension, but not the title this time, which, cool. For the record, I did also update the goal as well, so that now says permanence. I just didn't do the title, because I'm stupid. Oops. Imagine forgetting to update. Anyway, yeah. Let's go, yeah. So, I guess it's not quite the follow-up to Conquer the Blow Game 3 that impossible that I was expecting, but whatever, that's fine. If it's gonna go anyway, I think that's a reasonable way for it to end. At least it wasn't me getting upset because of the game being a problem at some point. I really should let, like, mods update my title as well for the 3 times that they have the opportunity for it. Yeah, my job isn't anything too special. I literally just, I move bags and boxes around in a warehouse. Somebody takes them off the truck, puts them onto a conveyor. Somebody takes them off the conveyor, puts them in front of my face. I take them from in front of my face and put it in front of a cage. And then either myself or another person takes them off the floor in front of the cage and scans it into the cage, because that's part of how the job works. And then when I go home, a driver takes it away from the cage and puts it in front of your face, hopefully. And that's how the system works. With a lot of throwing around omitted. Never look in a warehouse if you want to know what happens to your package. You won't like it. Does your package seem fragile? Well, maybe it'll only be thrown once or twice. Is your package not fragile? Well, that's good for you, I guess. Because it is going to soar. And that's my job. Dude, I don't get why this triggers so hard. But yeah, like, it's a night shift job. So I work from the hours of 11 to... Why am I so bad at that job? 11 to 7. 11 to 7.30, actually, is what the shift says. Generally, we're supposed to finish early. Like, normally I'd say we finish around 7, but like I said, the last week has all been 8 a.m. or later. It's been the worst. Like, almost as bad as how I'm currently playing at this save, and I don't know why this save is a problem now. In this run and the previous attempt that lasted 5 seconds. Like, I'm really bad at these cherry jumps, so I don't get it. There we go. Yeah, if your thing arrives in one piece, that's always a good sign. Dude, I can't do these cherry jumps, and I don't understand why. This is like the only hard jump now. The only hard screen out, the only hard save outside of, you know, the ending, obviously. Being what it is. Well, still here's to hoping that I can get the sub 140 finally. Ah, that jump's hard, fair enough. Like, I would say the only problem I really have with the job I currently have is just the fact that it's a night shift thing. I'm really just not doing well at Needle, huh? Well, this is going to be an interesting run. Hey, I did it, and I didn't die immediately. I'm really just not doing great at Needle. That's a problem. Like, I actually do quite enjoy the job I do, mostly because you just kind of tune out the whole time anyway. The biggest problem really is just the fact that, like, I do 2 shifts and it feels like it takes up 4 days. If I, like, genuinely, the last time I had a day off, I got home at Monday after being, like, out for the Sunday when I was supposed to be doing work. And it was weird because I felt like I was supposed to be working still. Like, where's all this extra time come from? I don't understand. Oh, it didn't clear. Man. Well, fine. Not dying is fine, at least. Cool. Yeah. As long as I don't die, it's fine for the last screen. That's the important part. Also now dies to gate jump. Hey, look, I said last time, like, my first death in Conquer the Blow game 3 was on a gate, so... Gate jumps are the scariest thing in Conquer the Blow game, on any of them. God, this song is loud. Aw, I missed the first shot, really? That sucks. Yeah, I thought that one would get stuck there. I just won't go for the third shot though, because that fruit kind of sucks. Oh, okay. Okay, so I guess it's just stuck here then. Cool. Alright, I guess this is the spot now. As long as we don't get the big fruit nearby for very long, it's fine. And it's over. Which, yeah, that's to be expected. Oh, don't do this to me. Don't just be stuck up here. Okay. Still ain't great. Like, I'm so bad at reading this part. It sucks for me. I really needed to just get stuck somewhere. But, like, this is pretty much part of the course, so... Oh! Ah. Oh. Oh, I was hoping we were getting stuck. Hey, I missed. Damn. Like, I'm so bad at reading the big fruit world. Damn it. Come on, hit the boss. Okay. Oh, that was beautiful. Woo! I'll take that. Like, the platforming wasn't perfect, sure, but you know what? That's fine! I'm okay with that! Yeah, sorry, Lemon, I'm afraid your statement is too many lines long to read while doing a speedrun. So... Something about work in a previous job is literally all I can get from that. And get one of the 6-inch bodybuilders. Dude, I'm timing this at the worst time. There we go. There we go. Hey, that was basically in time with the song. That was cool. I did it wrong again. Dude, I know I'm doing this wrong. There you go. It's always those fruit barely clip you on the floor. God, it's so loud. It's so loud, why? Like, I love this song, but man. I really follow up the longest sound of the game with the other longest sound of the game, huh? Oh yeah, now the poly sucker. Ah, I ran into the spike on the left. There we go. I'm not very good at that jump out normally, so I was trying to play a bit safer. I would love, like, to stop dying to that as well. Okay, well, that works. That was less dying. I appreciate that. Yeah, the death sound basically doesn't exist. Oh, the room. Yay. Yeah, on both this and the previous boss. Hey! Honestly, decent stage, I'll take that. That's pretty good. How that can go. Now I guess it's all up to Hibiki. Ah! Obviously this boss can lose a bit of time as well, but like... Hibiki is still the 6-minute time lost in the splits, so, you know. Feels like it's mostly down to her. Like, this boss can be a problem, admittedly. Like, this attack's actually hard, but at least it's consistent, I say, as I nearly kill myself. I Hey. At least it's consistent. Hey, we can hear again. That's nice. I do love being able to hear. All right then, well it looks like this is gonna be a good run overall. That's nice. Not a chance in hell it's gonna be like sub fail, for example, but like, I'm happily gonna take this run. If this isn't the sub 140, something very bad has happened that's gonna make me very upset. That's pretty much how this is gonna be. I'd say I guess I had to die to that at some point, but I really don't think I did need to. I really don't think that was a required death to manage at some point. Hey, first try on that, at least that's nice. Really. Yeah, so for the record, this game's turned down to like 55 on my Windows Mixer, and it's also 5% from OBS. This is easily like one of the loudest set fan games out there for some reason. I knew I screwed that up too. Buddy. I really come to dislike this save. It's really just a problem for me, and I don't know why. In many ways, like, it's the battle line corner that I've got there, which isn't actually a corner. I keep double jump bonking at the start. And then I keep screwing up the ending somehow as well, and I don't know how. And this save really should be first try, like my first couple of runs. How am I even bonking above me? Like, I'm not even full jumping. I'm not even full jumping! Like, I've stopped doing that because I keep dying otherwise. I hate this save so much. Like, it's really become a problem. And it's annoying because, like, my first two runs were first try once again, and I don't understand why. Oh, bollocks. Yeah, like, I'm starting to think I should. And I know what wall is good for, it's just that it doesn't feel like it should matter. Like, it shouldn't be necessary, really. Like, it should just be fine. You just full jump. Ah, this one's just hard. D-string nonsense. I just try jumping a height and I don't know what's good, honestly. Dude, come on. I swear I'm pressing jump in time. Oops. Ah, well. It was a really good start, at least. I really know. A really good start into some kind of silly mistakes here. Okay, at least the first try, this. At least I first tried that save, because that one tends to be a problem. Ah, fair enough. Nice. I love that I just accidentally skipped that so many times. One, two. Ta-da! Just jump a little high to make sure I don't hit that. Oh, okay, apparently that grows large. Straight up didn't know about that one. Might have seen that before and completely forgot. Ah, it's a double jump, really. That's unfortunate. I've been really good at this warp jump recently. What do you mean I single jumped then fell onto the warp? How? How did I manage to touch the one pixel of the warp on the way down, but not the way up? Please. Like, that's honestly just impressive. I straight up forgot about that one. I'm so used to just skipping it like that. I should have just didn't even realize it was there. I don't know why I'm single jumping for that. I don't think it makes a difference, so. Rigger, thank you. Oh yeah, Wolsk, I found out you can die in the bottom left here. So it turns out the bottom left of that screen, the warp is only in the bottom half. I guess. So if you double jump at the wrong time, you die. So that was cool. That was an interesting discovery. Yeah. I did not think that was making that gate there, but okay, I'll take it. I really didn't think I was making the gate with that one. Oh, good, because that last save is scary. Damn it. Okay. Alright. There are some times a jump really shouldn't live. That was definitely one of those occasions. But you know what? I'll take it, I guess. Huh. Ah, fair enough. Oh, come on. Way too close. I've really been struggling with the double jump today, and recently, and it's very annoying. Because I don't know what I can do about it. Yeah, that was way too low. Like, it almost feels like I should be doing the jump earlier and then... single jumping? I don't know. I don't know what I'm supposed to do better for this. That was a bonk. It's just a really hard jump. Really? I didn't jump that high. Yeah, this has just been a problem for me. So I'm assuming I'm gonna lose time on this split again, because considering how it was last time, I lost like 3 minutes on this split somehow. Which means I guess my PB was really good here somehow. I'll wait, I won't jump too high. Cool. Don't want to die to that again, thank you. That's always upsetting. This is very satisfying to do it fast. I can't believe, like, I don't know if it's gonna hit me until, like, tonight. That I have technically beaten Conquer the Blow Game 3 on Impossible. Because that just doesn't seem realistic to me. Because I wasn't even trying for it, you know? I just accidentally got it. Oh no, of course I'd still be interested. It's a Love Trap fan game, Lemon. What the hell are you on about? If anything, I'm more interested in testing that than Farewell Medley. It's not a slight for Farewell Medley, it's just that Farewell Medley's got a lot of crap in it. For better and for worse. If you're making a Love Trap fan game, I already know exactly what to expect. And it means I already know whether I like it or not. In this case, I do. So yeah. Thanks, Gothic. So nice, Evo Lemon. It'd also be cool test playing a game and finishing it within a day or two. Instead of a month. That'll be cool. Let's not die to the top row again, that'll be cool as well. Wow, I did it. Oh, it wasn't too bad overall, honestly. It's just the one save that went poorly. I can take that. However, this is the big deciding factor. How long does she screw me for this time? Okay, good start to the bounce again. Ooh, we got the fast cycle, okay. There is a chance, however, heads suck. I saw that one a moment too late. Because there was a giant head in the way. Well, that is immensely upsetting, because that could have been really good. Hey. Ah, okay, didn't miss at least. Shame! So I'm not getting that again. Yeah, so there she goes. Heads are the worst, man. Yeah, the RNG on the big head spawns while the small ones are still falling and is just pain. It really is. You're really just hoping it doesn't screw you over on that whole thing. Oh, come on! High bounces suck because it means you can't shoot for as much time. Like, it's fine with the arrow, obviously, because you get more time with this, but like, man. Okay, well, the big heads were good, so it didn't matter. Dude! What was that garbage? Come on! What am I supposed to do? Ugh, it's happening again. Like, you can see my gold on this. It started at, like, minus 10. That's how silly this is, because the first two runs I had first tried this boss. And then the RNG is just the worst. Yeah, well, gonna have to do two cycles again. Wow, that was terrible RNG. Dude, piss off. Yeah, no, that's fine. Like, it's such crap that you kind of just give up faith on it sometimes. Like, was that head dodgeable? Probably? Was it reasonable? Not really! Did I care about trying to read it? No. No, I stopped trying because it just didn't seem worth it. It's just like, well, I guess I'm dead. Ah, oh, that was so close to 5 as well. Like, it almost feels like you're required to be in the corner for this, but then the fruit obviously blocked that off. And then you just get the worst head RNG in the world, so. Such an ass boss to speedrun. Ah, oh, come on. Almost had that. It almost went straight into me too. Alright, how do we die this time? Hey, nothing. Buddy, don't do this again, please. I've had enough of this head crap. Hey, good attack. Like, still scary, and I have screwed it up before, but... Okay, good. Cool. Stupid boss, man, I swear to God. It's just the worst if you're trying to go fast, it really is. At least I get to follow up with one of my favorite stages, so... It really is just the worst to try to go fast on. Because the heads just aren't fair enough for that. Oh yeah, Wask, I said the last time this is your favourite stage. It's only because it's just a drum and bass song. Maybe I said a favourite song, but either way, drum and bass song. I'm a big fan of the song too, so. I don't know if there's another song in this game that you prefer more, but I'm gonna stand by that point still. Crap. Because one of the few things I remember from the VTuber overlay thing was that drum and bass is one of your favourite genres. I can't remember my exact wording, and I really don't know whether it was stage or song now. I'm assuming it was song. Saying favorite stage feels weird. Like, I really can't imagine I said favorite stage. I feel like it would be the song. This is drum and bass, right? I'm not crazy on that point, am I? Yeah, judging from the sounds of things, Lemon, I do have time still at least, so that's nice. Considering you said you have to make another boss still, so... Good save, by the way, buddy. Ah, I hate jumping too high on the ending. It's actually not too bad if you hug the wall. Like, the gate genuinely is actually pretty reasonable. Which makes it sad when I die to it. And now for one of the worst screens. Ah, it's a shame, because I actually quite like this stage, but then this screen exists. And by that I mean, like, this save and the last one. Mostly this save, but also the last one a bit. But this is still just, like, a luck jump to me. That was way too far to the left. Like, if anyone has a good setup for this, then feel free to let me know, but I've got nothing. Okay. Just seems like 5 frame, hope you make it. Really to that, though? Ah, dying to the diagonal sucks. Understandable. Yeah, dying to the, all of these jumps kind of suck, but, like, you gotta rush it, so... Buddy, come on! Dude! For the love of God! At least die to the hard part at the end. Well, I guess that was technically the end, so yeah, fine. At least die to the ending! Ah, yeah. See, that one I can accept. That's fine. That's a 16 pixel. That was me not jumping in time. Yay! Like, if it's on the ending, I don't mind the death so much, but, like, before the diagonals kind of suck. Hey! First try diamond still. Neat. Oh, that was the right one. Okay. I don't remember the order of anything. I never remember which warps I've just done, so I'm always just going to somewhere. Hey, first try that jump. I have been so bad at that landing recently, and I don't know why. Could not tell you the reason. Well, I feel like my needle will go a bit better than the last time I tried this, so that'd be nice. Ah, I made it. Like, I'm feeling much more confident in my needle today than I was last time. Which, that's gonna be very helpful, considering. For some reason I never realized you can just skip landing in that little gap, huh? Just go straight up like a four-block jump. Ah, hard jump. Never die to that 16 pixel, do I? Hey. Really, though? Some of my deaths are very questionable, though, that's for sure. Like, a lot of walking into spikes, it feels like, at the moment, for whatever reason. Yeah, I knew that was off, but I thought I was wrong. There you go. Please. There you go. At least I took the hard jump to be better on the save. I think the only time I... Well, never mind. I was gonna say the only time I died to this ending was when I was doing my first playthrough, but I've corrected that mistake now, so... Never mind. Oof, close. Okay, that's good to hear. Yeah, I didn't think that was going to be a problem, if I'm honest. But, like, they're also not intrinsically Love Trap fans, so that's good. That's always a good sign for it. Ah, first try. Ah, I got the bad wall, but whatever, I still did it. Cool. The save is shockingly alright until last, except for last jump. Like, it feels like all those jumps should be harder than they are. Nice. I was wondering when I'd finally bonk on that when trying to do that gate. Fair enough. That one's been a long time coming. Ah, and that's happened before. Unfortunate to die on this save like that, but okay. There you go. Don't skip the save, thank you. Even if the save isn't too bad. I am surprisingly alright at that save, and I don't know why, because that one is not easy. That is not an easy jump there. But I'll take it. Ah, I went too far for once? It's actually the first time I've gone too far for that, okay. Normally I go too short. There you go. Alright, eat. The jump that I seem to get surprisingly quickly, normally. Dang, I second tried it last run. Somehow. Yeah, there you go. I don't quite know how, but like, I'll take it. Definitely still faster than doing the regular route, even with all those deaths. Buddy. I hate how much I struggle on this save now, though. That's for sure. Because, like, yeah, dying on that part feels like it should never happen to me. The double diagonal I understand, at least, but I'd rather not. Thank you. Like, it doesn't... And there's my first death for that gate. Buddy. Woohoohoo is not going great, that's for sure. This has not been a good stage. Which, yeah, that's very unfortunate. Hey, I even got the skip, neat. Like, minus skip of not having to do the bottom, I mean. Oh. Yeah, this has not been a fantastic woohoo, I've got to be honest. I won't say it's been a terrible woohoo, but like, yeah, the hard jump for me. I'm pressing jump in time, give me a break. I don't know why it's so hard for me to tell when I can double jump on this thing for the ending. Alright, that still could have gone worse. Yeah, not a fantastic woohoo, but yeah, well, could have gone worse, I guess. Could have gone worse. I don't know why I like this stage so much. I know I say that every time, but I always feel like it bears repeating, because it really is just needle until the last save. And yet, for some reason, it's surprisingly fun. Like, with the music and the graphics and stuff, it feels like an adventure to me, despite just being needle. It's just one of those things that's like, it really shouldn't feel like more than needle. And yet... Son of a bitch. Happy needle. Yeah, actually, that's probably good. We need more of that. We've had enough depression needle, now we need happy needle. Like, that would be much better to have that. Posting that all over Discord, Delfruit. Hey, first try. That gate landing is surprisingly easy, and I always thought it was way harder than it is, huh? Reset for the cycle. I'm sure you can go faster on this, but you know what? I don't know how to do that, so I'm not gonna risk it. Ah, that's what I get for risking it. I still risk it in a different place. Woo, scary. Yeah, it sure is. I guess it's an effective outlook for a lot of people, so. Yeah, I don't see it going away anytime soon because of that. Which, you know, I'm sure it's good for people to have an outlet and all, but it's just at the same time, you know. Wow, look at the double diamonds they made. At least some of them are interesting, admittedly. Like, it is unfair to say they're all bad or anything. Okay, now I can actually read chat. Did one outdated SS in IWC for tester booting. Saving positive. I haven't shared the game publicly much. Gotcha. Always want to show stuff off. Yeah, I don't. I never want to show off things I've done. I like showing it all when it's done. The only time I've done opposite was for Save the Series because, well, they needed a cover for the blind game because people screwed up. So... And then it turns out the maker of Save the Series also screwed up, so that was cool. Yeah, a speedrunner's currently working on the needle stage too. I was like, hey, I've got like 50 lines of text for you to read. How fast are you? How quick's your reading? Is it Wolfie levels or like kindergartner? I'd say I'm solidly in between there. Hey Xander, it's going alright, how about you? Nah, I actually jumped early for once. Like, you're speedrunning a needle stage right now, you could read more than one line of chat, right? And the answer to that is no! No, I can't actually! Because I'm not even good at needle either. Whilst Dan appeared in the middle of this stage last time, it was very weird to me. I don't know why he started watching me a little bit. Like, he appeared in the middle of another stream as well, just to let Stinky know he heard Crimson Needle 3, Boys Are Back in Town, and thought of Stinky. Hey, I'll just hit that and go back now. Ah, first try. All right, cool. What's reading? It's something that entertaining streamers do, I think? Well, that is unfortunate. Of all the places to die, might actually be the first time I die to that one. I don't know if that's true, actually. There's a lot of, like, big-name streamers that just don't bother to read their chats at all because they're too big, so... I feel like most entertaining streamers read their chat, though. I know Small Ant does. I'm fairly certain, I lived. Ray does as well. Took me a moment to remember his name. The first time I've actually seen him chat in mine, though. Like, it's the sort of thing I feel like if he's gonna chat, it'd be after a Stinky raid. Like, Stonk hasn't raided me today. Why are you here? Interesting. God, that trigger's so much further over than I think it is. When Dan mentioned watching him, nice. Like, that's really cool. Okay, really just have to jump on that, huh? Alright, so apparently I didn't lose as much time as I thought on Uhuhu. And by that I mean somehow I saved time. How did I save time on Uhuhu? Uhuhu's a gold, right? Why is Uhuhu a gold? Okay. I stand by that not feeling like a great Uhuhu. I'm just gonna put it on I haven't done many runs of this game yet. What the hell? Uhuhu was a gold by a minute and a half. Okay. Well, this is the difference between me playing well and me not being able to play well, so that's what I'm putting it on. Like, today I've mostly gotten over all the sleep deprivation nonsense, which is fantastic. It turns out just not being sleep deprived helps a lot with being able to play a fan game well. This is the biggest reason why I surprised my second run of Permanence 1 was so good. Because I was still coming off, like, the extra shifts at work and being really tired, so... But it really feels like it just proves my point to me. Of like, the difference for me of like, being able to play while tired and one off. Yeah. The timer pretty much says it all. Conquer the Blow Game 3 Deathless kind of says it all as well. Like, ah, oh, please don't warn me on this attack again. That would be great, thanks. Okay. I'm not used to reading that far left. All I know is you mostly stay in the corner, and then at some point I forget to not move out of the corner. Yeah, I think that's the point I was supposed- No, 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 that one's the one I always actually stay in the corner for, and I die! Yep, no, it's fine, it's fine. I don't know why you'd ever think there's a problem here. I'm not nervous, you're nervous. Mickey definitely isn't nervous. She's chowing down. Hey, I didn't die to the boss, let's go! Ooh. Oh, that could have been a train wreck. Only mildly terrifying. My biggest time loss is still Hibiki. Because of course it is. Of course it is, that stupid boss and a stupid heads attack. Did the cool kids say? Crap, I'm uncool. Boss, are you also uncool? Yeah, that was a bonk. I don't think you can bonk this, honestly. If you can, you gotta be really far over for it. Because, you know, there comes a time in life, Boss, where you have to ask yourself, do you say poggers? Wow, I just, nope, don't like saying that. I am definitely not a cool kid. Like, of all the things I could say, that is not a word I'm fond of saying. I don't know if that was a double jump or I actually just jumped too low. Too early? Ah, barely. Pog fan? That is true, you are a bit of a Pog fan. Hoping for that resale value in 10 years. So, I hate it. God, I hate that. Yeah. There are some words from Twitch that I just don't really care to say, and that is definitely one of them. Like, I'm fine without that one in my life. I just missed the jump button. Fantastic. I tried to do a low jump to land sooner. Alright, I'll take that. Still haven't died at that gate, at least. That's nice. Hey, I actually first tried that save again for once. For some reason, the first save on this screen has killed me a lot, and I could not explain to you how. It's not even that hard. And yet. Ah, this save's always so difficult to first try. Last one's tough. Nice. This is going alright for Uhuhu. I finally died to that. Nice. Finally died to that jump. Goal of this save is just double jump quickly and you're good. Doesn't really matter how you do the gates otherwise. Hey. I stuttered it because I thought I went too far there. That's fine, this save's not too long, so. I've been really good at that 16 pixel recently, so that's a shame. I didn't feel like I was gonna make it there, but I don't know why I single jumped quite as high as I did. There you go, of course that one makes it. Really though? I was a bit confused I don't double jump in time for this drop, but all right. That, fair enough, that's just a two frame. Okay. They have to be 5 frames? See, I feel like I just do that a lot somehow, and I don't know how. Because I'm sure not doing it intentionally. And yet, like, I'm very successful at that save. And obviously I'm very thankful for that fact. I always think of that 3-spike thing in the middle as the Justice jump now. Just because of Justice Standard. Like, I do it a completely different way to how I used to because of that game, from having to do that jump too much. Also, just as easy, that jump exists, but Standard's the one I always think of it for. Because, you know. I finally died to that. Damn it. Ah, the save was gonna go so well then. I still don't know if it's okay to, like, walk off for that thing, and that's exactly why I always think about this jump here. Okay. Interesting turn of events we got. Okay, somehow made that, like, a double diamond. I bonked? Well, this is dying to a very different spot to what it normally does. That's unfortunate. Come on. Spending more than a couple of minutes on a save and needle is the worst. Especially when you've beaten the hard part 3 times already. Fantastic. Dude, come on, I'm pressing jump. Thanks, son. I press jump, yeah, and that's why I keep going lower. There you go, that's how I should have gone the first bloody time. God damn it. What a waste. Like, that's not, like, atrocious, but it is pretty bad for that save, for sure. Ah, I thought I had that first try. Jumped a moment too late. Okay, moment too late again. Cool. Really? Okay, first time I died to this save at the start. Cool. Getting some interesting deaths today, huh? Ah, I actually died to that. I kind of found a setup for this, which is like hugging the corner and treating it like a corner. And it's worked surprisingly effectively. Somehow, I don't even remember this part of this song. I guess it's short-lived, that's why. Yeah, this part I remember. I guess because it's also part of the song I don't recognize. Ah, okay, that's fast for mini spikes. Cool. Alright, I guess that makes up a little bit for the not T-bone thing. Four frame. That's a required 4 frame, right, Ross? Yeah. Like, I'm fairly certain that's nice. First time I actually screwed up the end there. I'm getting some very interesting deaths in this stage today, huh? That's actually the first time I messed up the double jump on that ending. Yeah, okay. I wasn't sure if it was like, it actually is too high, so I just don't get it. Bonk. You could double jump through it. I guess that's true. Eh. Eh. Well, that makes up for some of that nonsense. Saved on travel time right there. Not even I beat the save fast because I beat the save fast. It means I beat the save fast so I don't fall for as long. So that's cool. But do you have to 4 frame through it with a double jump, Stinky? That's the real question here. Stinky, did you see my tweet? I want to know if you're proud of me. I wonder if my friends are impressed with my decisions. Because I care about the approval. I'm not gonna beat around the bush for it. You didn't see my tweet. Okay, well, I did something silly again. And it wasn't even intentional this time. So, that was cool. I was going for a I just forgot that one. I was going for a bouncy, and then I did more than the bouncy required. That was neat. Yeah. Yeah. Technically, it's not impossible, because I did get the soft lock on the one screen. There's a warp bug. If you're falling at the wrong V-speed, it puts you into a block. But, like, I didn't die, so... That was cool. The bounty's for doing it in under 5 deaths. You think I accomplished that? Like, I thought of that moment as like, I feel like this is the moment where somebody says like, there's a thing as an overachiever. And that very much felt like an overachiever moment. That, like, you had to do under 5. And like, sure you did, but it's a bit overkill there. Thanks, Leonard. I play the sub a lot, but I'm busy, you know, having a decent run for once. Hey, Skull, did you see my tweet? You seem to pay attention to all the fangame news. I've been really good at the save recently. This is a shame. This save's been first try the like last three attempts. So it's a shame about this, but it is what it is. You did! Nice, good. Thanks, Levin. Does this mean I actually need to get decent emotes at some point? Oh no, that means you two can bop. That means you got the best emotes, so it's fine. It's too far to the left at the start of this, so not the greatest final stage, but that's fine. Yeah, morning, Stinky. Morning, Skull. How's it going? Damn it! I haven't died at the elevator in so long. For the record, I genuinely didn't think I'd... Like, I didn't know if I'd actually be able to do Conquer the Blow Game 3 on Impossible, because obviously it was considered when I did 1 and 2. But I really didn't think I'd actually manage it, so that was cool. Every time I hear the start of this song, I always think of the song from Stop the Meltdown. It's just something to do with the clapping in the anime. Always makes me think of that. Okay, well, there's the obligatory attempts. I always give the plane a few tries just in case, but like, I've never made it, unsurprisingly. Downwards plane and all. Like, it's a downwards plane jump, so... Man, fine, I'll just wait this time. Don't, screw you. Save should have been free. Yeah. That save's not going to be hard at all. I'm going to struggle more with this one because I can't figure out the landing half the time. I just kind of go for it and hope it works out with the 16 pixel or whatever the hell I'm doing. Dude, like... What am I doing wrong? I get it. I don't quite understand the save. But at the same time... Well, that worked somehow. I definitely felt like I jumped way too high, but sure. My mistake. Stupid deaths all over the place. Stupid deaths all over the place. Shame. Oh, come on, man. Well, this definitely won't be as good as the last time I did this split. Fair enough. Fair enough. That is a pity. I just missed the jump button. It's one of those things like when you know you can do it well, it's upsetting when you don't do it better. I'm not like hoping for world record or anything, but I can certainly see a lot of places that I can lose a lot of time very suddenly and upsettingly. You know? Such as any of the bosses or, you know, the fish. Because those haven't gone fantastically in recent memory. I'm not jumping soon enough and I know it. But if I full jump, I die. There you go. Reset for the cycle. Apparently even a small difference makes a big difference. I have no excuse for that death. I have no excuse for that one. I couldn't decide between jumping over and going under, so I just did neither. As is the way. As we just trying to rush. Come on, man. You've already got RNG hell at the end. There's no reason to go fast on some of this. Getting too panicky because it's like, oh boy, I could get the run finally. I could be done with the game. Yeah, that gold was really good, unfortunately. Reminder that, like, world record, aka fails run, is a 123.45. So, Maybe if this stage had gone a bit better, there'd be a chance, but even then, trying to beat his run would be pretty hard. And we're not trying to go for world record here after all, so. Well, balls. I just wanted to be able to see. I just wanted to be able to see the bombs. It sure is a section. Just wanted to be able to see the bombs, come on. I'd have to die to a fruit. Oh, come on. Alright, well, going fine. Doesn't seem to be coming in my general direction, so that's good. Just gotta give it time to give me a gap. Ooh, hello. Well, there goes all that. I've got a bit of a gap on the bottom here, so it's not too bad. I'm pretty sure it can get me on this wall, I just don't trust it right now. To, like, drop down further. That's a bit better. Definitely want to drop down further now. Well, I guess this is on par with the last run, because RNG. It sure is random. Okay. Ooh, you tried. Ooh, that was mean. I'm noticing some similarities in this RNG right now. Aw. Yeah, that was mean, right? There's suddenly two bombs on the side that I had to go for. Come on. Fine. Like, that ending was harsh. Well, I hoped. Nope. Okay. Please no kill on the bottom. Thank you. Okay, Zangief. Oh, come on! That was really good! You tied to bonking? Man! Ah, bonks are the worst way to go. Especially as that was a really good attempt, too. That was a bad read on my part, that's fine. Like, this layout isn't even bad for it, that's the problem. It's even worse when it's a two-block jump. Like, it's not like it's, like, Love Trap. And yet, I went for it. Worth a shot, at least. Nice. Well, that's unfortunate. That honestly makes quite a bit of a difference, unfortunately, too. Oh. Nice. That's not hard. Well, that is very unfortunate. I could go for these as well, I just don't trust it. Like, that's two hits left and I know it. I really just thought that would hit. Nope. Like, it's just too fast to be comfortable, you know? Off there. That, how did that miss? Okay, alright, nearly shot the wall. Yeah, well, not the worst time loss. Is the log trap layout? Is it actually? Huh, well, my bad then. I always thought the log trap layout was more squished. Ah, well, fair enough then. I guess with the platforms on the side, it feels more like the log trap layout. It feels more squished with that because of that. Alright, but. Alright, garbage. I hate this screen. Ah, oh, so much. It's long, it forces you to wait. The start is just the worst. And it's easy to die at the end because of the drop. I'm losing time on this split. I can already tell you. Dude, this... Oh, I despise this first jump. And it's easy to die to that as well, yeah. Yeah. And it's not even like waiting's any better, that's the worst part. Like, waiting for it to go up doesn't even help that much. It's still just as bad. Oh my god. This screen is the worst. Like, it shouldn't be that bad, and that's the worst part about it. Like, it really shouldn't be a problem. But especially with the restarting music, it's just so immensely upsetting. Like, this bottom part is kind of cool, but then you got this. Oh, you did the jump at the right time. Like, trying to hold right at the right time there is surprisingly not that easy. It's so easy to screw it up. Oh yeah, too early. Hey, I didn't die to that for once. Did we die to the- I forgot. Well, at least that's on me. Dude, seriously? Come on. That's the trigger I worry about, because I swear half the time I touch the trigger block and it doesn't actually activate. Yeah, I know we jump over you, don't I? That's what I'm gonna do. I'm sure there's a faster way of doing this screen, but I don't know what it is, so... Wow, that is not how I normally do that. Normally I double jump up, but I'll take it. I'll take not dying somehow. Damn it! Alright, well, the other screen could have gone worse, I guess, so... The one that matters was still terrible, but at least the one after was okay. Because, yeah, this split is entirely just those two screens. It's got two kind of nothing saves and the other two screens, and that's why I'm losing a minute. Minute and a half, yeah. And this boss will do whatever the hell it wants, so... Really? I got stuck on a block that started there? Screw you. Blocks are the worst. Cool. Well, try to shoot that one. Okay, that block's gone, I guess. Goodbye, block. Yeah. Oh, come on. Yeah. It's a boss. Look, I'm trying to hit the fruit to get it out of the way, please. There were two in there? Okay. Oh, come on. This boss was the worst the last time as well, unfortunately. Just tremendously slow compared to some of my original plays of him. Nice fruit spawn, buddy. Hi, yes. At least he made it so it doesn't kill you on, like, teleporting, so that's nice. That is something, I guess. Cool. It exists. It's a boss. thing. Dude, I've been really bad at this game recently, and I don't know why. There you go. I don't know why that gate's been the one that's been the problem for me, but it really has. Yep, there goes. Only 30 seconds, actually. Wario, that could have been worse. Okay, press jump before I hit the block, apparently. Good to know. Now for the stage where I have given up treating this like a block. It is now a platform. Of course, that time it sticks me. Because half the time I try jumping off the second block, I just double jump anyway. So it's just like, alright, cool, whatever. That's on me. And I did it right too. There we go. Permanence 2 extra patch. Oh no, there's more. That's the problem. Well, that'll be interesting when I get around to it, but at least I won't have to try to do it fast. So. Hey, basically first try. They're not very fun. Dang, that's a shame. Well, I'll look forward to them when I get around to it then, I guess, won't I? Gotta love that all the on-off buttons turn on at the same time, and that's why the sound's so loud. Also gotta love because there's a moving camera, and this is an 800x600 game. Like, the camera shifts down 8 pixels. I knew that wasn't gonna be good, but I had to rush because of the thing. There we go. As long as I don't die, that's fine. Okay, cool. Oh yeah, spotlight screen. Somehow I forget this screen exists. Probably because it's basically nothing. Really? That's actually the first time I've died on this save, nice. I think that's the first time I've died on this save. I think I might have, no, I might have died to the last jump once actually. Ah, you die once, you die 1,000 times, eh? Alright, cool. There you go. Okay. Well, fair enough on that one. Really? The block actually killed me, huh? Okay. My needle is all over the place today, I guess. There we go. I love not being able to see. It's great. Mostly on that jump, because I still don't know how to best do it. Alright, that could have gone far worse. And has gone far worse. Like, I died on the easy saves, but I actually first tried the hard save for once. Which, you know what? I think I'll take that trade-off. So it wasn't a huge amount of deaths on the easy saves, so yeah, sure. Fine, whatever. We'll go with that. Shoutouts to Falling Sprite. I'll never get tired of the Falling Sprite on this screen. I don't know why it's a thing, but... That right like 5 times on that drop in fear. All of this is just like a nothing screen that's built up for this. Why is this button so hard to hit? I swear. I don't get why that button is so hard to hit, but it really is. Buddy, why is this fish trigger so hard to hit? Seriously, why is that fish trigger so hard to hit as well? I don't get it. What's the 16 pixel gap in referring to? My memory is apparently scuffed. I will never get tired of this song. the button. I can't remember which button you're referring to. I was so focused on trying to make sure I don't die to the fish section that I'm not paying attention to this license. Like, I can't think past what I'm at. Like, this is where my mind is right now. My mind is fish. Like, there's a button, there's a 16 pixel shot. Where? No, I don't, that's why I don't go for the fast cycle there. It doesn't even save me extra time. Really? Annoying dying on the first day, but okay. I went too early. That fruit is kind of hard to hit. Dude, come on. This is an upsetting way to go. Like, this save specifically, at least I should know how this works. The second save is the one I should screw up a lot. I don't want to, but I can. Memory loss, I know, right? It sucks. I mean, it's a speedrun. Memory loss is a part of the process. I really should reset for the cycle. Yeah, okay, well, now I have to. Like, when it comes to speedrunning, memory loss is just kind of part of the process. I really thought the fish would get that one. I really wish I was more consistent with this save. I feel like I've gotten too many of these now. That's annoying. I knew that was there, but didn't manage to stop in time. I sure love how much I died of the parts I know on this save. Ah, there's just two fruit, that's why. I see. Ooh. Hi. Hi, I've gotten way too many of these eaten, apparently. Okay, that's a problem. No, 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 no. Don't really die to that. Nice. Okay, that could have gone worse. I'm okay with that. First save was kind of a real shame, but like, second save was good, so. Now let's not die in the last phase of this boss again. Screw you. Screw you and your spawns. Oh, I forgot about the blackout there. I really shouldn't be going that close. Oh, and now I don't have to, so never mind. You. This boss is really moving all over the place today, huh? Normally there's a bit more staying still than what I'm currently experiencing. Well. Can't exactly go up for that one. Oh. Oh, come on. Red Blue's about to hit her too. Really? Really? Now you stay still. Okay, screw you too. I'm glad I'm at least semi-decent to hitting these targets. Man, that RNG was not great. Speaking of not great RNG, these fruits and their complete non-existence. You know what? No, there's too many red fruit down there. I don't care for it. You move. Okay, screw you too. God damn it. Hey, okay, that's decent. I'm okay with that. Yeah, I'm a big fan of that boss as well, Lost. Alright, that was good! Hardly terrifying, but good. Oh my god, on harder difficulties, you're forced to do this controller jump from not this red block. Ugh. God damn it, Tuta. That sucks. That jump's a pain in the ass. Speaking of a pain in the ass, God, I would never want to play this game on very hard mode. Like, I think there's some things I find interesting as a challenge, and then I get to something like this, and it's just, ah, cool. My ability to hit a target is none, so... And then I've also got to do the double jump, and that's hard. Like, come on, how am I always late? Like, I can only do one of the two, I swear. Ooh. Ah, god, it's the screen that I don't know how to deal with. Hey, I actually dealt with it for once. Cool. I really just don't know how the bird works for whatever reason. Do, 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 do. Nailed it.
Whatever, that's fine.
2, 3, 4, 5. Yay, counting! Ooh, counting. Balls. Come on. I will say again though, like, shout out to Tutor actually color coding the saves though. I know it's a thing that, like, very rarely people do that. But I've always thought it was neat. Like, having the saves be different colours depending on their difficulties. Instead of just, you know, changing them all to the regular save sprite. Like, let alone, not even, like, changing the sprites manually so they're all, you know, blue and green and so on. Just actually having different sprite colours. Oh yeah, if you play this on very hard mode, you gotta do this thing at the end. Cool. I think this screen is just, if you play on hard, this is exactly the same as medium. There are no worse saves here. It's all hard. Okay. That was pretty fast, actually. Like, all of that screen is hard. Really? I'm a bit confused when I died of this, because I swear I do it right. Yeah, that was too high. That was a bonk, I guess? I don't know. There you go. And the screen with the save. Yep. And now we see if the jump goes okay. Last time it was first try. This time... Because this jump is balls. If anyone managed to find a good strat for this and this isn't somehow the run, then please let me know. Because I never want to do this jump again. Because I really hate it. Like, I was actually kind of upset that I first tried it last time, so there's no way I'm going to be able to do that consistently, and I know it, and that's the worst part. Okay, good. Like, that could have taken far longer, and has! I'm trying to jump lower so I can double jump higher, please. Also, loud guitar noises! Yeah, this screen in general is just kind of balls, I'm going to be honest. Like, the first jump of that save isn't great either. Alright, well, that could have gone worse. That's not a bad final stage. Yes, I consider the final stage done. Final stage is pretty much how does the Hoo Hoo 2 go. If well, cool, you win. Balls! Like, does Hoo Hoo 2 go well? Well, then, cool, your final split's good. I bonked? Really? Goddamn curve blocks. I do understand a couple of deaths on this, because I don't really know the timing. Yeah, but at the same time, goddammit. I wonder when I ever died to that one. I thought it was going to be from bonking on the other side, though. Not from that. What's wrong with a MIDI guitar, Wask? It's definitely not, like, 50 kbs less than everything else for some reason. I don't know why. I don't know why you'd have issues. Sounds perfectly audible to me. I really had to search for that word there. Oh, okay. That shuriken on the way back is always so hard for me. And that's why I'm always scared about the bonk jump, because it takes me an eternity to get to it half the time. Yes, there's this room. I actually straight up forgot. I just thought that was the last room for a moment. This is the last room, isn't it? I jumped way too late. Yeah, that's on me. Straight up just forgot this room existed there. Also another room that's exactly the same on medium and hard. Could you not, please? Come on, dying's enough, Rukito jump. There you go. But you just rush it, I know that. Oh, I thought I had it first try because I got the double jump. Alright. Well, that saves a little bit. Okay, clearly I don't remember how many rooms there are on this final stage. Apparently. I used to be so good at the save at the start of the runs. Okay, that's good still. I just don't remember how many screens there are. Which is the hype final screen before the actual final screen? I don't know. All I can say for certain is Uhuhu took me too long. This has not been a fast final stage. Hey! Oh, you're okay, now I know which is the final screen. Yeah, that's fair. Somehow not losing time. Wow. I guess I haven't done that many runs on this stage, so fair enough. I've only had, like, three completed runs, so that makes sense. Hey, first try, let's go! First try on here, girl! Nice. I will take that. Oh no, it's not world record pace. If I was only I actually only needed to be 2 minutes faster to be world record pace, huh? Alright, fair enough. Wow. I don't care to go for that. Really don't care to go for that one. There were obviously so- even though there were so many places that I could clearly save time on, yeah. I mean, it's the difference between like a modern day time and when Fail first got the run, so I can kind of see why. But at the same time, considering how old Fail's run is, I can definitely see why he thought there was no way he was beating it, especially for the time. Like, for the time, that time is insane. AKA, basically this time. But nowadays standards, it's like, how did you die more than 3 times a needle? But like, definitely for back then, that is pretty crazy. Like, that is a good run back then. This is the hard one. I don't know exactly where this spot is. Fair enough. That's fine. I've got 17 minutes to die to this, so... yeah, FailJguy was pretty good. Man, it really was just like an average run after the start. Like, final was not fantastic. It wasn't terrible, but it definitely had its flaws. Huh. Like, it started off great, and then the rest was okay, I guess. I don't know why. But, hey, I'll take it, as long as it stayed on par still. Like, not losing time is good. I'm getting the opportunity to look at my splits now that I'm, you know, not having to constantly move about. There is downtime here. That's kind of hard for that RNG. Alright, dodge the hard thing and then the rest is fine. Like, Fail actually goes to the right here, he doesn't stand exactly where I am. Hello, that's a lot of fruit. I didn't go... And I can definitely understand why, but I tried that once when in the last run and it didn't go well for me either, so I don't know if it's any better for me. Like, I really should have just learned a spot on the floor, I guess, but...
Too late now.
Balls. Like, once I pass it once, the rest should be fine, but that is definitely the hard part for me. That's actually kind of hard falling fruit RNG as well, I'm surprised. Couldn't stay in the middle for once. The fact that the green ones are bouncing really throws me off sometimes. Like, it's so easy to forget that fact in this mess. Because they go off screen at the end anyway. At least it only takes a minute to get to this attack, so that's good. Hey, a gap. There you go. Yeah, I'm not gonna say that spot's flawless or anything, but it's the one I do, apparently. Nothing else should kill me. I realize those are famous last words after all, but... Couldn't remember if you had to jump that one or not, and I didn't trust it. Oh yeah, I still have the scary pattern. Of course, yeah, the five fruit that build up. Like, the five fruit that build up honestly feels more like a boss attack than an avoidance thing to me. And I really like it. Stay in the corner, move out the corner afterwards, till otherwise you screw up. There you go. Yeah. I mean, I don't normally stay in the corner there, but I couldn't read it fast enough, so... Alright. Now, this is the one I always call the scary attack. Like, this attack really isn't that difficult. It's just, with the way it builds up, it's very scary. It almost feels like a boss attack to me. It really does. Yeah, with the jumps here. Woo! Every time it makes me nervous, even if it's not that bad. Every time. I'm waiting for this to be the first time I die to finally. Which will be very upsetting, but at the same time, not surprising, I'd say. That is the one jump I always remember. There's the one, that's the scary one. Iffy on the ending there, but still. That one jump over there you've got to do. I couldn't remember when it was coming, so I was a bit off there, but hey, it worked out. Good run. Very happy with that. Now to never run this again. Like, if you like the game enough, I could definitely see this being a very fun speedrun. However, I'm okay with being done with it there. I don't feel the need to improve. Sub 140 is enough for me. Oh god, there are just some moments that are just very, very upsetting. Like Hibiki in that one jump in Uhuhu 2 in the medley stage. Thanks, wonderful. Overachiever. Em, did you see my tweet? Because, yo, Void, you have no idea. Oh, man. Let's just play some ding sounds then for the subs, because, yeah. Wait, is this really loud? It's not really loud. Okay, we're good. And two for Lemon. Thanks for the subs, guys. I appreciate it very much. Oh, that was honestly a really good run. I'm actually very happy with that. Like, not even just, like, cool I got the goal. No, like, 128 is actually pretty decent. I could definitely see why, how 123 could be beatable. If I cared enough to go for that, which I'm good, thanks. Been here the whole run? Oh, what, for Conquer the Blow game, you mean?